When you're living with a terminal diagnosis, you're reluctant to start new friendships, new connections, new relationships. You're terrified of doing that because, you know, you invest so much time and then you're worrying, oh, is this person actually going to be, you know, there for me? Are they just going to run away at the first sight of, you know, when the cancer rears its ugly head again? And the other thing is, you know, if you actually invest a lot of emotion and you build something with somebody else, well, with that idea that you're going to die comes in the picture, well, it, I can't swear in this, can I?
Sure,
no.
You can.
I can?
Yeah.
It's a shitty thing to do to somebody. It's a shitty thing to do. You just, you know, create this new thing. And then, oh, by the way, I'm dying now. Bye. See you. Oh, it's a shitty thing to do to somebody. It was such a hard thing for me to come to overcome, because I did end up making new friends. I did end up, you know, connecting to new communities. The cancer communities, they're fantastic, but that's actually a huge one where it's hard to be a part of a cancer community because so many of your friends end up dying. So you end up living that way. You end up with that burden. And I've had to find ways to justify every step of the way because it's not an easy thing. And yeah, and even I'm in a new relationship now and it's going fantastic. It's going phenomenal. And yeah, it's something that I've had to work towards coming to terms with, but it took me a while.